How do we get interest in practicing? Well, hell of a question this. Because once you know that playing and practicing are different, people say practice 3 hours, but they're not practicing, they're just playing songs there over and over, and that is not upgrading your playing. So real practice is to practice, to do an inventory there. The teacher does that through a proper assessment, and then you go to try to master things that you are weak at. This is practice that really upgrades your playing. To do that is an art, and this, you cannot do it alone. It's like asking someone to do his own dental work alone. This is not possible. Then, but in Skype we are doing that, and if you want, you can join anytime from scratch up to the highest level and start the study program properly, and I will make sure you get there. So this one thing is very important, because otherwise how we will get interested in practicing? When you understand what practice is and you get interested into it, then you will become very good player in no time. No matter what, for sure. Believe me, it will happen. And I have seen tons of people or students doing it, doing that. Doing very high level of, getting very high level of efficiency. Why? Because they became interested in practice. Not in playing pieces like a parrot. If you memorize a poem in Arabic or in Russian, that doesn't mean you know Russian. You don't know the language, you just repeat like a parrot thing. That's what people do with guitar. That's what we don't want to do. Unless you want to, then like one guy came and said, I want to be a parrot, can you help me? You know, and yeah, I said yes. Because he said, you said that you can learn anything you want in this school, in CFE, with your project. And then, can you do this? They answer yes. But you know, that's his goal. That's not what I advise, of course. But he wants that. So unless you want to be a parrot and just repeat things without understanding, you need to get knowledge. And then when you get knowledge, then you will become interested in practicing. Because it's actually very interesting and very much fun. It's all about you, first of all. And that's why it has to be addressed, the topic of how to practice. How to practice more important than what. If you see on YouTube, there is plenty of what to practice. This lick, this piece, this thing, this skill, this and that. It's just what to do. But how you will do it, that is the real thing. That is the real deal. And then once you find out that, which we do very easily, because I have the method to do it, if you have the proper supervision there and then record your homeworks also on unlisted videos, etc., then you will see how you become more and more interested in practicing. Why? Because that will actually upgrade your playing. And you feel it, because when you play, the person who has to know in this homework recorded and all that, who's the one that sees if he's advanced? It's you. You will see how you advance there yourself. So, of course, I see it also. But the first person who has to see it is you. And then when the guys notice that, wow, I am really playing better. And because you feel it, this. And it's true. Because it's objectively true. You said, scales at this speed, rhythm at this speed. This is a metronome. This is friend. This is not an enemy. Don't feel comfortable in his presence. It's a friend. So then, therefore, this tells you, yeah, you are good. Put the check mark. And then you feel. You actually, it's true that you play better. And because of the, because why? Because you became interested in practice, in proper practice, which means with supervision and proper gradient and proper amount of what. It's just like self-medication is dangerous. So then also this alone, you cannot do this. This is why I said, do it yourself and be confused forever. This is one motto, because it's very true. And that's why Paco never did a DVD of teaching, because he said, I don't believe that someone can learn these things alone. Right? You need a teacher, maybe in blues, there's plenty of do-it-yourself stuff there, but this is all about what to do, not how. How is how you will do it. I also tried to learn some things there, but what is it, but yeah, but maybe, for instance, I'm very interested in the technique and the compositional techniques of Alan Holzman. And then if I want to learn, but I need a teacher, so I got a friend that is also a teacher of that, and I may join this thing and then understand really how it is, because otherwise I'm just guessing out things. because that's also very complex. So that also I don't think it works like this in the do-it-yourself philosophy. So this thing here, you save time like anything. And then that's how you get interest in practice, because you feel that you play better and it's true.
Yo lo que descubrí ahí es la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería. Cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien. Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.